In this devlog, I will show you how I went from this to this. Hey everyone, I am creating a virtual tabletop to play Dungeons & Dragons with a first-person perspective, like a Roll20 meets Skyrim. And we have reached an exciting next step of development. Throughout the previous devlogs, I have created a foundation that will serve as the base for the development of this game. So now it's time to start making this look good. And I will start by improving on the DM map creator portion of the application. So, as the meta for this devlog, I wanted to improve the terrain maker of the DM map creator. And what does this mean? So far, all we have is a plane with a customizable size. And I wanted to expand on this by allowing the DM to sculpt the terrain in runtime. But before doing that, I did a quick sidestep in order to add color to the imported objects. You may remember that I used an asset to import 3D models in runtime. And in the asset, it says that it allows for texture loading. So implementing this probably wouldn't be hard. I put it in the blender and quickly painted this 3D model that I have been using. And when saving it, it comes with these two files. One is an MTL file and the other an image file, and they function as the necessary files to load the texture. The model importer automatically handled the loading of the texture for me. But this meant that in addition to the 3D model file, I now had to include these two extra files into the save system if I wanted to continue using .obj files. But hey, we now had colors in the game. Look at that, so pretty. Now, back to the terrain. How could I achieve what I set out to create? I saw two options. One would be using the same plane I already have and finding a way of sculpting it, much like 3D modelers do in softwares like Blender. The other would be to try and use the terrain editor that Unity already has, but in runtime. After searching online, I thought that the best course of action would be to use the built-in Unity terrain, because if I could achieve a runtime version of what is possible in the editor, it would instantly give me access to a lot of tools relating to terrain customization. So I swapped the plane I had for a terrain and got to experimenting. As can be seen, when I create a terrain object, the following options under Paint Terrain appear. Out of them all, we would simply need to try and recreate: raise and lower terrain, paint holes, paint texture, set height, and smooth height. I felt that with all of them, we would get a satisfying terrain builder that could achieve pretty much everything that the DM might want to create. I started by focusing on the raise and lower terrain feature, and through some search, found this script on the Unity forums that, while functional, needed a lot of work, because while it did everything I wanted, it really wasn't as precise as I wanted it to be. Basically, Unity's terrain can be seen as a matrix, and each location of the matrix has a height value. And what this script was doing was, based on a brush with customizable size, increasing the value of every point inside that area by a customizable strength value, making it look like this. So that wasn't going to work. So I decided to go into the script and edit the way it affects the terrain. My objective was to achieve an effect like this, a gradient-like circle. I felt it was the best way of achieving a good feeling while editing, because it made the point in the center be the one with the biggest value, and it wouldn't make the square-like appearance that you can see here. So I booted up MS Paint and got to drawing. Thinking of it as a matrix again, I knew that the center point of the matrix would be the one where the value would be 100% of the strength inputted, and then, going around, it would decrease until zero. This was harder to do than I first thought, because since the size of the brush was customizable, I needed to be able to create an equation to automate this. And after a lot of trial and error, I got it to work in a way that was satisfying to me. Here's how. But before I make you run away from my channel with the following explanation that will resemble a math class, if you're enjoying the video so far, please consider subscribing to always stay on top of the development of this project. Okay, so this will be easier to understand by visualizing an example. Imagine you pick a size of 9 for the brush, so a 9x9 matrix. First, what I do is find the center of the matrix, since I know it will be the point with the biggest value. Then, I find the value that I will use to subtract. This value will be based on how big the size of the brush is. And with these two values, I can now find the percentage value of each matrix position by multiplying the subtraction value by the distance to the center position. Super easy, am I right? I simply had to translate this into code, and while not really a circle, it creates this pyramid-like shape that does the job well, and I feel works with terrain sculpting. And just look at how much more dynamic and interesting the maps now become. Here I am quickly throwing together some hills with zero planning behind them. And then, when I switch to the first person view, damn, that already looks so much better than before. With that out of the way, I was confident I could achieve the same, but apply it to texture paint, since it worked almost the same in the editor. And I was right, I just needed to understand something first. And that was alpha maps. In Unity's terrain, you load your terrain object with a bunch of textures, and then it creates layers for those textures. Those layers are the alpha maps. Then, going back to the matrix example, in each point of the terrain, it stores a value for each terrain layer. So, if you want a part of the terrain to be a grassy field, it makes it have a value of 100, and the rest of the layers have a value of 0. And why am I explaining this detail? Because it creates a limitation for my terrain. After searching online, I am positive that it isn't possible to load textures into the terrain at runtime. So, this means that I'll have to load the terrain myself with a big collection of textures, or maybe find a workaround for this limitation. So, taking what I learned before, I created a similar script for this functionality, but applied it to the alpha maps instead of the terrain height. I then loaded the terrain with 5 different textures, ending up with this. Look, I am painting the terrain.
It's working! It's working!
Now, adding together the 3D models with colors and the terrain deformer and painter, I was able to create this little scene. And this already gives a whole other feel to this VTT. And what is this? Oh yeah, I revamped the UI of the editor, but I'll leave the development of that for the next devlog. So, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to always stay on top of this, the Metas project.